3GPP is a partnership program between seven standard development organizations, SDO, across the world, that they got together and they create a partnership program to create specifications that they can adopt then in the different SDOs.
The work is done in a collaborative fashion by different member organizations, and the results of those are then transmitted back to the member organizations that publish them as national standards.
It really has been this successful partnership program which has produced the specification of the different generations of cellular systems. And as we now are in the full evolution of LTE, we are also starting to work on the 5G because, of course, our partners really want us to develop a 5G system which will also make the IMT 2020 submission for ITU-R and will basically address the connectivity needs of our partners for the next decade.
In this particular case, we have a set of shared objectives that we've been able to glean through work that's been done in many of these regional organizations, that NGMN being one of them, and 4G Americas, organizations in each of the regions. And these organizations have basically produced vision and requirements. The basic requirements are coming from IMT 2020 through the ITU. And in the end, what 3GPP will do is produce standards to satisfy those requirements.
There are different views on where operators want to deploy the new radio and exactly the use cases for the new radio. But looking at the whole approach, we have decided that we are going to design a fully capable system meeting all the IMT 2020 requirements by beginning of 2020, where there will be the release 16 freeze in March 2020. By that time, we will have a fully capable system meeting all the requirements. But at the same time, the emerging consensus is we will do an earlier version of the 5G specification with not addressing all the capabilities, but addressing some more stringent market needs that are a little bit earlier than others. And for that, we will have an earlier release in mid of 2018. Again, addressing only a subset of the use cases and the requirements, but based on the market needs we will establish. You can already see some emerging earlier market needs, but we are not making any decision at this point in 3GPP. At the moment, we are going to start a study looking at the broader picture, try to address, have a design of the new radio and platform which is flexible enough so that all the use cases will eventually be addressed. But when time comes in 1.5, 2 years to decide what will be in the first release of the specification, this early release of the specification by 2018, we'll make some hard choice on this goes first and this will come later. Now, one important thing is, given that we have decided that we'll have this phasing, and it's important that we make sure that we design our system so that we can add capabilities to the platform in an optimal way. And to do that, we have decided we'll have to have a design that is forward compatible at its core.